backpacks. Man, that was when Ethan was pushing the Subaru hatchback. Man, I'm talking way before hashtags. I was running through the six with my woes. Yeah. I was running through the six with my woes. You know how that shit go. You know how that shit go. You know how that shit go. Running through the six with my woes. You know how that shit go.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Hope everybody's staying safe during this pandemic. My name is Song, and today I wanted to do an unboxing for one of the most coveted pairs of Jordans to drop in 2020, the Jordan 1 Mochas. Now, these first surfaced on the web at the end of last year and the beginning of this year, and since the pictures of the shoes leaked online, the sneaker community have been going crazy to get their hands on these. Now, the resale for these shoes are about $380 to $420 right now. So, you know, there's still a pretty big hype around these shoes right now. Basically, a lot of people are saying that these are like the knockoff Travis Scott's because the colorway. And I can see why, because, you know, it mirrors the similar colorway with the brown suede. But, you know, regardless of what the colorway is, Jordan 1s are probably one of the most hype pair of shoes to hit the market in the last couple years. And, you know, everybody's been going crazy for pretty much every pair of OG Jordans, especially like a colorway like this. So I was able to get my pair on sneakers, the app, Nike app. I actually ended up getting two pairs, so I actually ended up selling a pair to a friend of mine, and I have a pair here for everyone to see. And I will unbox them very soon. But before that, I guess a little information about the shoes itself. I believe these shoes first released in 1986. And I think back then they were like around $90 to $100. But, you know, people weren't really hyped over ones for the longest time. I mean, I think some people were, but not everybody were. Myself, I really liked, I used to just mainly get like the 11s and, you know, 4s and 5s and, you know, maybe like 9s or the 10s, but I never really paid attention too much to the 1s. But yeah, I mean, the hype is big right now on those. So these shoes actually dropped on October 30th on Halloween, and, you know, obviously they sold out everywhere, and a lot of the foot sites sold out immediately as well. A lot of the raffles, you know, it was very hard to win as well. I entered a bunch of them. I didn't hit any of them on a raffle. But from also what I heard was that a lot of the local stores, like regional stores like Foot Locker and Finish Line, didn't end up getting their pairs. Their shipment was delayed, so a lot of the raffles, in-store raffles, were canceled like a couple days before the actual raffle itself. Now, without getting too far into the conversation, these are the pair I actually got in my size, the Mocha Jordan 1s. As you can see, it says Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Black Dark Mocha. Yep, so that's the box right there. And the shoes right here. So this is the right pair. This is the left pair. As you can see, I laced them up in the sales laces already. These shoes actually came in two sets of laces. One being this black one that was already stock on there. They were the stock laces, I mean. It was already on there, but I swapped them out for these sale ones because, I don't know, I feel like it just pops and it gives it the shoes more character. So let's see. As you can see, I already laced them up and I already wore them like a couple times. So there will be on foot pictures of this at the end of the video, so make sure you stay tuned to see those. All right, so let's get into the shoes. Starting with the toe box, it's black leather, not too different from any other Jordan 1s. The leather does seem a little softer than some of the other pairs, other ones I have. But it's just like the regular black leather that comes with a lot of other ones. Moving to the Vamp, it's like an off-white sail color. Pretty soft creases. It looks like, it feels like it's not too tumbled. Like I have a pair of the Royals and I have a pair of the Bred ones. And I feel like those actually are tumbled more than these ones. But all together, pretty good quality. Feels like it will break in nice. I'll probably end up, you know, wearing it a few times and putting some leather conditioner on it so it breaks in, like it creases and breaks in much nicer. Moving to the mid panel, it's that same sail color, that off-white. But I would say the leather on the mid panel are better than the Bred toes and the Royal ones. Yeah, it's pretty soft. With the Nike swoosh on it, sail laces. The tongue is also sail as well with that Nike signature, Nike tag on the ones. The inside tag, the insole right there, size 8. The collar is leather as well, off-white sail color. The Jordan Wings embroidery right here, embossed. And this is probably the best part of the shoes, which is the brown suede, the mocha suede that's on there. It's pretty good quality. Maybe not as like soft or plush as those Travis Scott's, but they are nice. I would say these are pretty good quality shoes, pretty good quality suede. The midsole is off-white sail color as well. The sail seems to be like the color that Nike have been going with a lot since like the since Virgil Abloh started dropping his off-white, the fours, the sail fours, probably one of the most hyped pair of shoes to hit the market this year. But yeah, it's pretty nice. And then finish with the sole of the shoes is black sole. But yeah, all around these shoes are very nice. I will give these shoes 9.9, anywhere between 8.9 to like 9.2. It's hard to say. But yeah, but what I did notice is I had two pairs of these in hand and I like compared the two. I think a lot of people do say that Jordan brand quality control is not the greatest. And I really noticed it this time around because I had two of the same shoes and same size in my hands. And they were like different, quality difference. The other one had like, I feel like better tumbled leather on the toe box, but not as soft on the side. So, and the other one had like better shape, I feel like. It had like more of the Bred toe shape that I saw on my Bred toes, but all around the shoes are great. I mean, I can't even, you know, complain. I had ended up getting two pairs. So, you know, little minor things I don't mind at all. But yeah, stay tuned for the on foot pictures. Hope you guys enjoyed. You can follow me on Instagram at sung_ohm. But the S is with the 5, so it's 5. SUNG underscore the number 0M. Also, I'm on Twitter as well, Sunny Gomez, SUNNY underscore GOMIS. So, hope everybody enjoyed, and maybe we could do another video soon. But stay tuned for those on foot pictures. Peace.
Yeah. Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something. They just spent like 2 or 3 weeks out the country. Them boys up to something, they just not just bluffing. You don't have to call, I hear my dance like Usher, ooh. I just found my tempo like on DJ Mustard, ooh. I hit
that Ginobili with my left hand.